You're welcome to this video tutorial. This is RTO management. It's a Visual Basic project for the students who are doing CS course and they need to do project as per the curriculum. So in this video, we'll show you the complete details like how to make this project, how to design the database tables, how to run the project, how to enter the data. A lot of things we'll explain you in this project. So as said already, this video is very suitable for the BE, BCA, BSc, BTech, diploma students who are supposed to do a project in Visual Basic or in any other language like C#, Java, Android, Python, or web application. So you require an idea like how to make. So this video will serve the same purpose. So RTO is a regional transport office where you can get LL, then DL, okay? Then vehicle registration, vehicle transfer, vehicle renewal, all these activities will be taken place. So this we need to understand how these works will take place in RTO and how do we write the program and how do we make application for this and how do we help the RTO department with this application. So this is the main idea. So understanding the whole concept of RTO is a domain knowledge and what is the language used, the programming language. So that is the programming skills. So combining this, you can make this particular application. So let us understand what are things we include in the RTO management. Right, okay. So here, as I said already, so this RTO is a regional transport office. So if you talk about the scope of the application, so this you can know like this RTO office is present everywhere throughout the country and there are many branches and even every country there is a RTO office and we keep on working on this same application and you make such an application that it should be useful in every country, then the scope is really worldwide. So therefore whenever you select the project, you see to it like its usage should be very broad. What I'm telling is when you beginning, okay, you make a small project, that's fine. But once you get into that project only and you keep on improve that such a way that it should serve all the purposes. In that case, so you'll come to the extreme level and then ultimately everybody will use the same. Then the scope becomes wider and definitely you can get a good amount of money from that. But anyway, that is all different story. But now let's come back to as far as a mini project is concerned, what we can do in this project. Here is regional transport office. So we provide a login form for this. So every project is supposed to have a login indicating that how do we log in, how do we verify the data, whether the particular user present with the correct password or not. If the user with the ID and password, so then you can allow them to get in, otherwise we can stop them. Then you can have a MDA form, so where MDA stands for multiple document interface. With that you'll have a menu bar. So via menu, you can able to navigate with the rest of the forms. And then you talk about the vehicle registration. So vehicle registration will have vehicle type, what type of vehicle it is, what model it is, which company it is. So these are what you call the basic entries we need to do. Therefore, when you registration, we can call all these data over there and then we can select the particular vehicle model and the particular vehicle company. So based on that, we can have a registration. So new vehicle registration. This is a new vehicle registration. After the vehicle registration, then actually you need to make the renewal. And if they sold the vehicle, then you need to transfer the vehicle. Transfer. Along with that, generally we'll cover the DL and LL and the DL. So each one will take one form. So therefore you can look at the number of forms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and with that there is at least 3 to 4 reports, so put together it is 14 forms. So 14 forms is okay, ideal for the mini project. So here in this video we'll show you all the forms, so therefore you get a complete idea so how these forms are designed and how do you make this project. So then next is the advantage of the project, because once you select this project, you have to tell them advantages, why you selected this project, what are the advantages of this project and why you need to do this. So here, when you talk about the desktop applications, I need to select the pen first. Okay, so let us select the pen. So when you talk about the desktop application, so that can be compared to the manual work. But anyway, we are came long way. So from almost 30 years, we are developing the softwares, and we are already in a peak time. So almost all types of applications are already developed. But anyway, we need to venture into that again, and then let us look into that, what we can do more. But today there are a lot of new things we can implement to that. That you can do it in a future announcement. But as for this project is concerned, what are the advantages is, so data can be stored securely. So your data, once you enter to the system, it will be stored, and you take the backup, your data is secure. Search will be easier. So any registration search, any transfer, all can be done quickly. Entry will be very easy. So whatever the data is required, we can pull the data and we can show on screen. So therefore, we can do the work faster. So these are the advantages of the project. Apart from this, like any desktop application, what are the advantages there? Even it's applicable to these projects too. So this video, what I'll show you, it's developed using a Visual Basic. So we'll show you all the forms once you run the project. And the backend, we are using Microsoft SQL Server as a backend here. But options are very much open. Again, what language you're using, correspondingly suitable backend you can use. For example, if you use Python, you can use MySQL. So if you use Java, you can use Oracle, like that. So I'll show the demo now. So if you're not yet subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. So your subscription will definitely help us to bring good content and good videos in this channel. So therefore, don't forget to subscribe here. So please subscribe. Any of subscription is free. You don't need to pay anything for that. So just log into your YouTube account and then click the subscribe button. And if you found this video is useful, please click the like button and also share with your friends or your junior students who are supposed to do projects. So please share the video. And also, like, if whatever feel like, what do you think, or you want to ask some questions, please write it in the comment and then click the comment button below. Let us know what you're thinking about. Links are provided here. Please click on the show more button. So below there are links. So you can use the links to learn VB.net, to make like login form, to make a MDA form, you make a client form and validations. Lot of things are there. So using that links, please watch that videos too and learn like how to make the complete project. Okay, let's move to the project demo. Fine. So here we open the project in Visual Studio 2019. You can see this is a solution explorer. All the forms are there here. And here is the server explorer. You go to view menu, then select server explorer. There you have data connections. And there is a separate video like how to create the database, how to create the tables and all. So please watch that one. And here we have all the tables. I'll show the design of this table. If I open the definition, you can see there are three columns and here is the data types and here the corresponding SQL statement. And same a DL table. So to store all the DL details, this is the table. So here, what are the entries are done via form. So that we'll going to store into DL table. So here is the DL form. So here you can see the form. So what are the entries we do? It all go to the DL table. So same way, there is a LL table. So what are the data we collect for the LL? That will go to LL table. Receipt table, what are the money we collect from the user or the customer or the applicant who come out there for the DL test or LL test, that money will go to the receipt tab. Renewal, so this is the vehicle renewal. So once the person comes for the renewal, the data will go to this table. This is the user table. And this is the vehicle company table. This is the vehicle table. So this is a registration. So once the registration taking place, the data will be transferred to this vehicle table. Then vehicle transfer, you transfer from this one to another person, the data will come to this table. Then this is the vehicle type. So wish to write down means then you can pause the video and write down all the table names. And then you need to design a SQL server. Fine. So now I'll show one of the two forms here. Okay, first I'll show you one simple form. So simple form is vehicle type form. So only there are two fields are there here. So this is the vehicle type table, and two fields are there. What are the entries written? It should go to these two fields. So here is a new button. When you click new, you want to clear the text boxes, and we'll focus to the text box one dot focus. That means cursor will go to that, and then we are enabling and disabling the buttons. It is a type of validation. So because all the buttons are enabled, user simply click on every button, some errors may occur. So in order to avoid this, we are enabling and disabling the buttons. When you click save, we'll take to this save record. We'll check whether you enter in the text box one or not. Then we'll check whether it's a duplicate or not. Then we'll go to insert the record. So please watch some other videos from our channel. So in each project video, we are explaining some of the other code in a different way. So therefore you can understand easily and you can able to write your own code. So next, here is the grid. When you click list, so we are sending the data from the table to the grid actually. So this is the code, so to send the data from selecting from this table to grid. And when you click on the grid, again we return this code. So select the particular record from this particular table, and then we can transfer back to the text box 1 and text box 2. Again disable and enable the buttons. So next you can modify. So here is the modify button. So first we're going to delete that record, then we are inserting again. And delete, we permanently delete the record from the table. That's how you need to write the code. I'll show you one more bigger form. So vehicle registration form. I can see that number of fields are quite huge here. So when I click save button, so again you can see that we'll check whether you enter the data in the text box 9 or not. Then you can see that that insert statement is quite big. So as it becomes bigger and bigger, probably you'll get errors, so you should be carefully manage column name and the corresponding values. Then we are combining both the variables q1 var and q2 var, and we are sending to cmd1, that is SQL command. Then cmd1.execute non-query, you should insert the record. Once it's inserted, you can give the message box. That's how we'll insert the values to the table. And here you can see that there is one more report. A report is almost like already we see like how to display the records in the grid. Same way here is also. So here is connections, and then here is the SQL adapter and data set. So we'll have a SQL statement here to select the values from the vehicle table. That will go to ADP. ADP to DS1, that is a data set. That is DS1.table of 0. That moves to the DG1 data source. That is DG1 is the data grid view. So here is the data grid view. So this is the DG1. So this is the data grid view. So all the data will be pushed to the data grid. So here we have rows and columns. You can able to view it in a rows and columns. So that's how you need to write the code. Fine. So let me run the project. So this is RTO administration. Simple picture here, so you can redesign the whole picture how you want. Then is a login form, you have to log in here. Fine, so small issue. So earlier is a SQL Express, actually now it's a local DB because this is a 2019, and this is the corresponding connection string. So you can able to see the connection string here. You can see connection string, and here is the connection string complete. This is what you have to copy, and then you have to paste it in the module. And instead of taking the path, we take the data directory, because this will take the complete path automatically, because this is a global environment variable. It will fetch the path. Right. So now I'll run this. Right, so here you can see that is a user ID, this is admin, then admin, then okay. So main entries, vehicle types. So here you can enter the vehicle types, so two wheeler. So then you can say car or four wheeler, okay, like LME, so what you call is LME, light motor vehicle. So this is a light motor vehicle. So all cars comes under this particular category. HME heavy, so bus, car, bus and all heavy vehicles. So then vehicle make, let's say Maruti. Maruti is a car manufacturer. Maruti Suzuki. Next is vehicle models. So here is Maruti. Model name Maruti Swift. Okay, so we take LME. So this is the one model, okay. So this detail I'll write as save. So these are the basic entries. So next here is a receipt. Whatever you want to do, you have to pay the money for that. For example, you want to give the vehicle registration, then you can see the name from whom you are collecting. Let's say Ravish. So for vehicle registration, you need to pay 25,000 rupees. So details. So this is a vehicle registration and the remark, cash receipt. Right, so save this. So that means you have paid the, generally in RTO, if there is a challan, you have to fill up the challan and then you have to give it in the cash counter. They collect this and they'll enter into the database. So now you can go to vehicle registration. So first you need to check out the receipt number here. So 1021002 is the receipt number. And here you can see vehicle type. Fine, so here is a vehicle type. So it's a LME two wheeler. So it's a LME. So this is a registration number, K05M1234, and registration date, owner name, let's say Harish, and then father name, some Ramu, then address, then state, which state it is, Karnataka, then district name, Bangalore, and here is a vehicle make. So this is a Maruti, and what is the model? So this is the model. And so it is a Maruti Swift LME. Engine number, I have to write the engine number, chassis number, then what color it is. So here color you can say white color, and year of manufacture, this is 2020, and the receipt number. Okay, so receipt number, that is 1002. Okay, save this. Receipt amount is 25,000 rupees. Okay, it'll show that one. So then the record is saved. So it is done and the record is saved. So next is the driving license. You can say LL. So you can apply for the LL, fill all the details and you have to save. It means you are applying for the LL. And same way you have to go for DL. So once you pass the LL, then you have to give the LL number here. Then you have to give the DL number. Then you have to, once you give LL number, automatically all these data will be get filled up. LL number, this is the LL number. Okay, so here I'll give the LL number. So all the data will be get filled up. So next is the vehicle renewal. So here is the vehicle number you have to give. So let's say K05M1234. So you can see that all the details will be come up. And you can have a mobile number here, 1234. Then fee receipt, for everything you need to make the payment. Receipt does not exist, okay, fine. So close this. You go to that vehicle renewal. So this is vehicle renewal, cost you 5,000 rupees. Details, this is a vehicle renewal. Save. Number is 1003. Now you have to come back here. You have to enter the vehicle number, M1234. The details will come and now you have to give the receipt number. Amount is 5,000, okay. So then save, the record is saved. So that means renewal is done. So my vehicle transfer you can do. So first you have to give the vehicle number here, K051234. Then who is the next applicant? All the details you need to fill up here and then you have to save. Based on that, there is a report here, vehicle registration list. Two vehicles are registered. LL list, there is one LL, then DL list, there is one DL, then you have vehicle renewal list, so two other, because this one we done now, two vehicle list, and then receipt list. So what are the money collected? That list there. You can take the printout of this and you can submit. Fine, so these are the things which is there in RTO. Hope you understand this and you could try this to do yourself, and if you complete, you're really happy, then you can learn a lot of things. So please try all this, and if you have any difficulties, let me know what is the difficulty. And again, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.